Hello everyone, welcome to another Magic Arena Deck Tech. I'm super excited about this one because we are going to be doing a format that doesn't exist anywhere else. We're going to be doing Quick Singleton, one of my favorite things to do on Arena. I'm really glad they brought it back. I had wanted to do a Deck Tech on this exact deck before, but they took it away just before I could. So really excited to show off today, but I want to give a quick shout out to all of my subs and patrons. Really do appreciate it. And of course, to my wonderful sponsor, Ink Gaming. You can check them out at inkgaming.com and make sure you use the promo code that's down below. They serve a bunch of play mats and dice bags and other cool things that you'd use for accessories for all of your tabletop and like Magic gaming, and it's real awesome. In any case, this quick singleton match that we're going to be doing, we're going to join up right now. We're going to do with a deck called Single Mom. I can't take credit for that name, although it's amazing. This is from Arkham Archivist, who named it, but it is all about Muldrotha and Mom, as she is affectionately known, and Singleton. So it's a bunch of single cards with Muldrotha. Really, really awesome value Sultai deck. I've done a few different versions of it. There's certainly things that can shift around here, move in and out, depending on what your actual collection looks like. You could certainly run like a Nissa Steward of the Elements. You could run, say, I've seen Tezzeret, the mono blue Tezzeret from M19 in here. There's a ton of things that you can use, but this deck is a monster. It's all about the synergy of getting things into your graveyard and then getting them back out. You use things like Search for Azcanta and Champion of Wits. Other things like Liliana, Death's Majesty. Really recommend that you make sure you have Liliana's Death's Majesty if you want to do this deck, because it's just incredible with all the synergies that you have. You're going to be using it to mill yourself, same with like Champion and Search. And when you're milling yourself, then you can constantly get that value back, because you have a bunch of different ways to do that. You have Muldrotha itself, where you can play permanents out of your graveyard. So when you're doing things like plus one-ing Liliana and putting two cards into your graveyard, you're actually just getting two extra cards, because you can just play Muldrotha and play those cards back. They're basically just in your hand. That's the idea. You can get it back with, say, like Eldest Reborn. You can do things like Nissa Vital Force, -3, you return target permanent from your graveyard to your hand. So you can just constantly rebuy these things over and over and over. And you also have even lands that help you with that, because you have Memorial to Folly, which is right here, which is 3, sacrifice it, return target creature from your graveyard to your hand, so you constantly get that value. Mending of Dominaria is another really key piece, because you just put 2 cards from your library into your graveyard, immediately return a creature from your graveyard to your hand. So not just from the 2 that you milled, obviously. You can get them from more, and so that's, again, the Liliana, Search, and Champion of Wits just really helps get that ball rolling. A lot of the rest of the deck, as you can see, it runs 26 lands, just an absolute monster amount of lands, is a bunch of ramp spells. So Llanowar Elves, Channeler, Drover, Naga Vitalist, Servant of the Conduit, with Beneath the Sands, Grow from the Ashes, and an Hour of Promise, which I've really liked, because it can help you out in board situations where your opponent's getting a little bit too far ahead of you and they're able to pressure you if they're maybe a bit more of an aggro deck. And then you can kind of come back, get a bunch of zombies, and also you ramp yourself a whole bunch so you can land something like, say, a Sandrum Convergence and fully stabilize. Oh, another card that's actually really good for getting things into your graveyard is Jadelight Ranger, because you just graveyard basically everything. Everything that you see, you just throw it into your grave. Doesn't matter. You'll always be able to get it back. Always might be a bit of a stretch, but people for some reason haven't been running Scavenger Grounds, they haven't been running Graveyard Hate. So hey, you know, I'm cool with it. Like getting Spring to Mind into the grave is a good thing. You can get Vizier of Many Faces into the graveyard, the Champion of Wits you can play out of the graveyard. You have a bunch of things that just constantly give you value for having stuff in your grave, and that's really what you're trying to do. So there are some pieces that you can move in and out. Like you can certainly run some more spells, and you could say run Torrential Gearhulk and instead do that kind of a thing. But just remember, keep those graveyard synergies in mind all the time. Always make sure that you have a bunch of ways to get things out of the graveyard. I've made sure that with this deck we have a lot of different like permanent types. So you have a few artifacts, a few planeswalkers, a few different creatures you're going to want to get back, some enchantments, all those kinds of things, because Muldrotha's specific wording is you can play up to 1 permanent card of each type. So you can have like a land, then you can get an artifact, then you can get a creature. So it's nice to have a bunch of different things like that. We also have Gaunti, which I highly recommend. Just like key pieces of this deck that are just really nice to have. Gonti is fantastic. Everybody's playing really, really powerful spells. Using Gonti to steal one of them is pretty nice. It's been very, very awesome for me. I've really liked Gonti. I could maybe see taking out Vizier of Many Faces and switching it out for some things. I'm not sure what I'd want to. It's always the best creature on the field, so it's tough. I mean, sometimes it really saves you from situations, but a lot of times it's a little bit slow, so I'm not 100% certain what I'd want to do with that. But yeah, I mean, this deck's just been an absolute blast. I still love Sandworm Convergence as a finisher. I wasn't sure if I'd like it or not. It's 8. It's super expensive. But the deck does have a little bit of a problem with flyers, so Sandworm Convergence stopping them from being able to attack you that way is really nice. Another key piece is for yourself. There are a lot of cards like Sandworm Convergence that are artifacts and enchantments that are really hard to beat. Something like Immortal Sun when you have a whole bunch of Planeswalkers and locks all your Planeswalkers out of the game. Or like an opposing Sandworm Convergence. I've seen Cruel Reality. Thrashing Brontodon. Really important. Destroy target artifact or enchantment, and you sacrifice it to do it, which means that if you have Muldrotha or Mending of Dominaria to get it back, or Liliana, or all those kinds of ways, you can just constantly recur it out of your graveyard and always blow up all of your opponent's artifacts and enchantments. So Thrashing Brontodon is super, super useful. There's many, many times where I've just been constantly being like, oh, I'd win this game if I just grab it. I don't think you can play this deck without it. There's way too many good artifacts and enchantments running around. So that's another very key piece of the puzzle here for this deck. But this is a little bit of an idea of it. Like I said, you can certainly move pieces in and out. Like I could see changing Nissa Vital Force, maybe running Steward of the Elements instead. This does return permanence, but the Scry on the other one is also really, really nice. Like, there are some shifts that you can make here and there. I would recommend, if you can, River's Rebuke has saved me a number of times. It's very, very powerful. But there's a bunch of them. Like, I'm not running things like Verdurous Gearhulk, for example. I'm not running Rush Me. I'm not running, you know, the Nissa Steward of Elements. Like, there's a bunch of things that you can kind of swap in and out a little bit for. But this is a pretty nice little start, I think. We're going to run it through the gauntlet and see how it goes. So stay tuned for all of the games.